Hi, everybody. My name is Buddy the Elf, and I want to welcome you to Heritage High School's theater production of Elf the Musical. Don't be a cotton-headed ninny muggins and forget to turn your cell phone off. That's sure to get you on the naughty list. There will be one 15-minute intermission, and snacks will be on sale in the concession stand by the gym. Ooh, I hope they have syrup. It's my favorite. Now sit back, relax, and have a great time as we present Elf the Musical.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Good morning, good afternoon, boys and girls. Welcome to the North Pole. Would you guys like to hear a story? How about the story of Buddy the Elf? Well, he thought he was an elf, but we'll get to that part. Our story begins once upon a time here in the North Pole in a little town called Christmastown. Now, this town is unique for two reasons. One, there's no Starbucks. And two, everyone who lives here is an elf. Christmas elves enjoy themselves by donning gay apparel or by singing songs in Santa's shop. Of course, I always like it when they sing a Christmas carol. I like it even better when they stop. Night and day, they dance and play. They never sleep much either. Would some peace and quiet be a crime? Of course I love each one of them, but Santa needs a breather because they're just so happy all the time. They're oddly happy all the time, ungodly happy all the time. When they sing until they're bluish, Santa wishes he were Jewish. They're happy all the time, I swear they're happy all the time. Bizarrely happy all the time. But there's an elf called Buddy who makes them look apathetic. He's everybody's buddy, but he'll leave your eardrums ringing, cause everywhere he goes he has to tell the world he's singing.
Yay! It's almost Christmas and I'm singing, and I love Santa so I'm singing, Santa!
Buddy, that just cuts through my brain like a knife!
Sorry. Can I give you a hug?
Ask first, then hug. Remember?
Sorry.
Personal space. Just breathe. Buddy, you've got toys to make. The big day's only 2 weeks away. Let's pick up the pace. Oh, and Buddy, don't forget, every kid in the world is counting on us.
Oh, time to work.
How you doing, Buddy?
Fine, Charlie, but I think I'm gonna be a little short on today's quota.
That's all right. Now tell me, how many Etch-A-Sketches have you finished this morning? Come on, how many?
I made 85.
85? It's 10 a.m. and you've only made 85?
Why don't you just say it? I'm the worst toy maker in the whole wide world. I'm cotton-headed ninny muggins.
You're not a cotton-headed ninny muggins. You have lots of talents. Special talents. In fact, special talents?
You're the best basketball player in the whole North Pole. Even better than Santa.
You're the only baritone in the Jingle Singers.
You bring us down a whole octave.
In a good way.
See, you're not a cotton-headed ninny muggins. You're special.
Yeah, special.
Now, these elves are getting quite thirsty. You mind doing a run on the cocoa cart?
Yay, cocoa cart.
Hey, Tiara.
Yeah, Charlie?
I hate to do this to you, But then you can pick up the slack with those Etch-A-Sketches.
No problem.
I appreciate it. Buddy's killing me.
Hey, that was quick thinking with that special talents thing.
Yeah, I feel bad for the big guy. I just hope he doesn't get wise.
Well, if he hasn't figured out by now that he's a human, I don't think he ever will.
Human? I'm human?
Oh, no. Get Santa, quick. She's really fast.
Yeah.
You said I'm human.
No.
No, not you, buddy. We were talking about some other buddy. Somebody else.
No, you weren't. I'm not happy. I'm not happy.
Way to go, Tiara. You broke his heart.
What do you think I meant to do that?
Well, it's kind of a hobby of yours, isn't it?
Charlie, don't make this about us.
My hips aren't happy. My thumbs aren't happy. My lips aren't happy. My gums
Buddy?
Aren't happy. Santa, is it true what they said? Am I human?
That's a good question. I think it's time I told you a story. Come sit on Santa's lap. Ooh, big boy. Buddy, once upon a time, there was a young woman named Susan Wells, and she had a baby. But soon after the baby was born, she passed away. That baby was placed in an orphanage, and one Christmas night, he crawled into my toy sack. By mistake, I brought him back here to the North Pole. The elves raised him as one of their own.
Really? Who is he? Is it Charlie?
No, buddy, it's you. It's your story.
I'm not an elf. I'm a human, and I'm an orphan. Just like Annie.
No, not exactly. You see, your father's human, but he just doesn't know you were born. And he lives in a faraway land called New York City. And he works here, in the Empire State Building.
In there? He must be teeny tiny.
Trust me, it's a very tall building. Keep it as a gift for me.
Aww.
Elves, there's nothing to see here. Back to work.
Well, what's my dad like?
Well, your father's a very successful executive. He publishes children's books.
Ooh.
But, buddy, I'm afraid there is something I have to tell you. He's on the naughty list.
No! What did he do? Did he wet the bed?
No, he didn't wet the bed. He just doesn't believe in me anymore.
Doesn't believe in you? Is he insane?
No, he's just lost the Christmas spirit.
But the Christmas spirit is what makes your sleigh fly.
I know. It's becoming a problem. Buddy, I think it's time for you to go and see him. I'll miss you, that's for sure, but you're like a bird, a big, hairy bird, and it's time for you to fly the nest.
But I don't want to go to New York. I'm scared.
There's nothing to be scared about. New York's a wonderful place, but there's something I need to tell you, and it's very important.
What?
There are like 30 Ray's pizzas, and each one says they're the original, but the real one's on 6th Avenue and 11th Street.
Okay. Which direction is New York?
South. We're in the North Pole. Everything's south. Just head south until you find yourself in a big, smelly, industrial wasteland.
And that's New York?
No, that's New Jersey. Then you're gonna go through the Lincoln Tunnel, and you're there. Bye, buddy. Take care.
Bye, Santa. Hey, wait. What's my dad's name?
Hobbs. Walter Hobbs.
Then that must mean I'm Buddy Hobbs. Yay. Dad who's a million miles away. When he meets me, who knows what he'll see? But deep down I know I shouldn't be afraid, 'cause he's bound to be a lot like me. And we'll make angels in the snow, till the snow begins to blow. Then we'll run inside and start a tickle fight. And if it's too cold to sled, we'll eat gingerbread instead. And then cuddle till he tucks me in at night. And we'll have
have our pictures taken for the Christmas cards we're making. Him and me in suits of matching plaid. And when people see us walking, they'll be Google-eyed and gawking at Buddy and the world's greatest dad.
Bye, Buddy. I hope you find your dad.
Thanks, Mr. Narwhal. We'll spend mornings holding hands and making plans on whether to play jacks or kick the can. Then for lunch, a ginger snap, then a nap to fill the gap. Team building forts and playing Superman. And if his back gives him a spasm, well, every good dad has him. I'll bring him cocoa and a heating pad. It's a scene inside a snow globe. It's a very apropos globe. Just Buddy and the world's greatest. We'll share a whole fruit cake slice by slice, making sure not one single crumb drops. And if I were to say I'm in a Christmas play, he wouldn't miss a 4 million gumdrops. Woo! And if all is great, my knee, he'll kiss that knee for me and make that boo-boo better in a chip. If I should get a cold, worse allergies from mold, he'll soon tie me with his own handkerchief. I can hide my admiration for that perfect combination of Buddy and the world's greatest dad.
Get out of my way!
So I'm gonna try my best to be everything you'd expect from me. I promise that I won't stop until I'm done.
Jingles, the Jolly Christmas Puppy, it's tanking in every bookstore in the country.
Why?
Because there's two pages missing from the last chapter.
What?
Without them, the end of the book, it makes no sense.
How did that happen?
I don't know. Well, you yourself okayed the final proofs. We'll have to recall all copies and reprint.
No, we won't. Kids don't even read the books anyway. They just look at the pictures. No recall.
Are you sure you want to do that?
No. I want to go the green way and say we're taking a $50,000 bath so some stupid five-year-old can find out what happened to Jingles, the frickin' puppy, on Christmas Eve.
But...
But nothing!
Whatever you say, boss.
Deb.
Yes, Mr. Hobbs?
Coffee now.
Right away.
Hello, darling.
Hi, Dad.
Ready to go?
Go where?
I don't believe this. Christmas shopping, remember?
Emily, you always do this to me.
I've had this planned for weeks. I had to take the day off and I had to pick up
Michelle. Well, I can't. I'm swamped. It's my busiest time of year.
Dad, it is well documented that the children of workaholics are prone to self-esteem issues.
What?
What can I say? The kid likes NPR.
Can we please continue this delightful conversation in my office away from the staff?
Excuse me. I'm here to see Walter Hobbs. I'm Buddy the Elf.
Buddy the Elf? Oh, what a riot! You look hilarious. Who sent you?
Santa.
Santa?
Uh-huh, from the North Pole.
From the North Pole?
Yes.
Well, I'm sure Mr. Hobbs would be delighted to meet with you. But he's in a meeting right now. So if you wouldn't mind waiting a few minutes.
Oh, of course.
Stay here. Can I get you anything? A coffee or a
chocolate milk would be fantastic.
You always try to make it sound like it's my fault. I just can't. Today's impossible, isn't it, Deb?
Oh, yes, Mr. Hobbs, you have a very busy day. 1 p.m., meeting with the staff, lecture them on the board's behalf and condemn, giving workers carte blanche.
My job has many facets.
And want to chat when you're through. Lecture over at NYU on outbidding Taiwan.
And liquidize our assets.
Choose a date for the meeting with Global Freight.
Try the 25th.
Walter, wait!
No one works on that day!
See, Christmas always gets in the way.
You got it backwards. She's right. It's you who is getting in the way of Christmas, Walter.
Honestly, Mrs. Hobbs, it's out of his hands. To chat when you're through. Lecture over at NYU on outbidding Taiwan.
Well, it's my alma mater.
In the car, meet new sale demands. Au revoir to your dinner plans. Tell HR they'll be working till dawn.
Or else they're in hot water.
Employees under Mr. Hall, aren't you pleased? Just to keep your coffee, no, he's more content
when all together now, Christmas always gets in the way. What's the Bing brew? Ha ha, over fa la la la. It's a childish ordeal. I mean, flying reindeer, let's get real. Old Santa's sleigh just brings more bills to pay. So I gotta work or feel the squeeze. Money doesn't grow on Christmas trees.
Let me see that calendar. If not today, then how about tomorrow? 1 p.m. Lose the title, sir. She's your kid. Don't make fun, there's too much to discuss.
My budget needs rewriting.
2 o'clock, skating in the park, then a walk. Until after dark, here's a shock. Spend an evening with us.
Yay, Mom and Dad are fighting.
Have no doubt, it's that time if you think about how I'm buried here. Help me out.
It's all working, no play.
Everyone back to work. Dad! Who the heck are you?
Oh, Mr. Hobbs, looks like someone sent you a Christmas gram.
All right, let's get it over with.
Meet Buddy the Elf.
So, I guess you came from the North Pole?
Yes, that's exactly where I came from.
So go on.
Go on with what?
Aren't you gonna sing us a Christmas song, or can I just get back to work?
A song? Sure. Yeah, anything for you, Dad. I'm here with my dad, and we've never met, and I was adopted. We didn't know I was born, but I'm here now. I found you, Daddy. And guess what? I love you. I love you. I love you.
Wow. That was weird. You know, usually guys just put my name in the jingle bells or something. I think we should call security.
But Dad, it's me, your son. Susan Wells had me, but didn't tell you about me. But now I'm here, I found you, it's me, Buddy.
Susan Wells, did you say Susan Wells?
Isn't she the girl you went with in college?
Susan passed away years ago. If this is supposed to be funny, it's not.
Well, he said he's your son. Deb, who sent this Christmas gram?
I don't know, Mrs. Hobbs. He came without a gift card.
Mrs. Hobbs, are you married to my dad?
I'm married to Mr. Hobbs.
Then that means you're my stepmommy! Would you like a hug?
No, thank you. Wait, he's my brother? Shh, no, of course not.
Listen, buddy, some nice people are gonna come take you away from here.
But I want to stay here with you, Dad. Hey, look, we have the same color eyes.
You do?
Oh, come on, they're brown. Deb has brown eyes. Does that make her my daughter?
Actually, mine are blue.
Ow, Mom, you pulled my hair.
I did? Oh, I'm sorry.
You got a problem here, Mr. Hobbs?
Yes, get this elf out of here.
Will do, sir. Let's go, buddy.
Hey, that's me.
Where do you want us to take him?
I don't know. Take him to the North Pole.
Sure thing. The North Pole, no problem. They got one at Macy's.
I just came from there. I walked. It's 3,408 miles. I took the tunnel, but if you take George Washington Bridge, it's a mile shorter. Who knew?
Here you go. There's a North Pole right in there.
There's another one?
Have fun.
To Macy's Jungle Passion Fruit Spread.
No.
That's fabulous. Welcome to Macy's. How are you today?
I'm great. I just met my human dad.
That's fabulous. Are you an out-of-state visitor?
Yes, I'm from Christmastown.
We'll be sure to stop by our visitor center to pick up your discount card.
Oh, I won't be buying anything. You see, I only have chocolate money most of the
time. That's fabulous. Jungle Passion Fruit Spray.
Fruit Spray, sure.
Hey! What section I assign you to?
I don't know.
You don't know? All right, you work right over here, the North Pole.
That's not the North Pole.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. Where's the snow?
Why are you smiling like that?
I just like to smile. Smiling's my favorite.
Well, make work your favorite. Work's your new favorite, okay?
Okay. Santa always likes it when the people see all those little people are hard at work. Hard at work. The big guy.
The big guy?
Yeah.
The big guy from up north?
That's the one.
Did he send you down here?
He sure did.
Corporate, always checking up on me. Okay, we're gonna be good friends, good pals, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Now, if you don't mind, I have an announcement to make.
Oh, of course.
Thank you. Attention Macy's shoppers. We'll be closing in 5 minutes, but 10 a.m. tomorrow, Santa Claus is coming to town.
Santa! Oh my gosh, I know him, I know him.
He'll be here to take pictures with all the children, 10 a.m. tomorrow.
10 a.m. tomorrow.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
You, could you go help that girl over there with that tree?
Oh, sure. Santa always liked it when I helped decorate the tree at the North Pole. Oh, she's beautiful.
Yeah, but try talking to her. She's nuts.
She is? I love nuts. Hi, I'm Buddy the Elf, and we're going to have fun together.
Hi, I'm Jovi the Elf, and I seriously doubt it. Enjoying the view?
Oh, yes, you're very pretty, like a glittery angel. I'd like to stick you on top of the tree.
Classy. You know what? I'm not a Christmas person, so dial down the elf speak, okay?
Uh-oh. Sounds like someone needs to sing a Christmas carol. Don't you know the best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear?
I don't sing.
Oh, come on, it's fun! It's like this. I'm singing, I'm in a store, and I'm singing, I'm in a store, and I'm singing.
Hey! There's no singing in the North Pole.
Yes, there is.
No, there isn't.
Santa always liked it when we sang.
He does? I'm singing, I'm in a store, and I'm singing. Come here, just come here. All right, see that guy over there? Home office sent him. He's a professional. So you gotta do everything he says, even if it means being here till midnight.
Midnight? We have lives, you know.
Then what are you doing here in an elf suit?
Wait, stop! This isn't the right way to decorate for Christmas. Don't you care whether Santa likes it or not?
Hey! Take your meds and get to work.
Decorating for Santa isn't work. It's fun. You just have to get into the Christmas spirit.
Yeah, the Christmas spirit.
We can do it. All of us together. There's a saying we have up north that helps put our best foot forth. If you want to deck the halls for Mr. C, make sure they're sparkle, jolly, twinkle, jingle-y.
What the heck is that supposed to mean?
Just more of that usual home office bull, Dickie.
When a room is gloomy and its atmosphere has called it quits, then you must remember that December is a time for glitz. Never stop until each limb on your Christmas tree is sparkle, jolly, twinkle, jingly. Pick up every ornament that's sitting, waiting on a shelf. While you're busy decorating, why not decorate yourself? Soon you bring a smile to every person you see.
I'm sparkle, twinkle, jolly, what?
Close enough. And if you're at a loss, remember the phrase that says to thine own elf be true.
To thine own elf be true.
For when it comes to Christmas displays, look inside and you'll know what to do.
You'll know just what to do. Put some cheery folder all on every wall and every nook. Tinsel up each corner till it's Christmas everywhere you look. Give the world a holiday that's bright as can be. Make it sparkle, jolly, twinkle, jingly. One heck of a job. Y'all can all go home early.
Yes, thank you.
Oh, gee, she's so pretty.
Well, why don't you ask her out then?
Out?
You know, take her to dinner?
Eat food with her?
You know, like take her home, show her a good time.
Snuggle under the covers, get out the flashlights, eat fluffer nutter.
Whatever turns your crank, buddy.
Good night.
Hey, wait a second. Would someone like a hug?
No. Would someone like a punch in the throat?
No.
So good night.
Wait, do you want to eat food?
Do I want to eat food?
Yeah, you know,
Are you asking me out on a date?
Yes, right, a date, that's it.
You don't want to go on a date with me.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Why?
Well, because I like you, and I get really warm when I'm around you, and my tongue starts to swell up.
Your tongue swells up?
Yes, yeah, that thing.
Well, it's weirdly nice I make your tongue swell up, but I just don't see this date happening.
Oh, of course. You probably already have a date tonight anyway, obviously. You have probably have guys asking to eat food with you all the time. Lunch, dinner. I bet you have a different guy for breakfast every morning. It's dumb of me to ask.
What the hell? I'm free Thursday.
Thursday? Thursday, yes! This is going to be the best Thursday in the history of Thursdays.
You know what? I find if you lower your expectations in life, you avoid a lot of disappointment. Don't you have a home to go to?
Oh, yeah, sure. A nice home with a big bed and walls and a ceiling and everything. I think I'm just gonna stay here and put up some more tinsel.
Seriously? Okay. Well,
Santa's here. Open up. Send the kids.
Santa, yeah, it's me.
Hey, buddy, how you doing?
It's me. Who the heck are you?
What are you talking about? I'm Santa Claus.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
You little boy, what do you want for Christmas?
I want Call of Duty.
Don't tell him what you want. He's a liar.
Let the kid talk. I want Fortnite.
You can't have that. It's too violent.
I wasn't talking to you!
You disgust me. You don't smell like Santa. You smell like beef and cheese.
Just cool it, Zippy.
You sit on the throne of lies.
Look, I am not kidding. Get out of here.
You were saying, kid? I want Minecraft.
It's reprehensible.
You're reprehensible!
You're a fake.
Oh, I'm a fake. How'd you like to be dead?
Look, he's not really Santa!
Help! Somebody's video Santa!
Whoa.
Hey,
down.
Come on,
Hey,
come on,
come on.
Easy.
You're not corporate. You're crazy. Arrest this nut. And you. Get out of my store. I'm Santa now. Wait, Santa can't run that fast.
He wasn't really Santa. He was a liar and a fake.
Calm down. Tell us your name.
Buddy the Elf.
You got a last name, Buddy the Elf?
Hey, I do. It's Buddy Hobbs. You know my dad, Walter Hobbs?
No, but we'll locate him while you're cooling your heels in a cell.
Thanks. My heels are incredibly sweaty. How did you know?
Doesn't work.
Well, maybe you've got these little spinny things on backwards.
I don't know. Dad said he helped me, but he's not around. Again. He's basically not a dad.
Michelle, don't talk like that. Your father loves you, and he's a very kind man, but sometimes he's just... Hold that thought. Come in.
Hey, Mom, I'm home.
Excuse me?
this the Walter Hobbs residence?
Yes.
Our pal Buddy here says that Mr. Hobbs is his dad.
Oh, yes. Officers, we are aware that Buddy thinks he's Mr.
Oh, good. Looks like we've got the right place. Let's go.
Oh, no. You cannot just leave him here.
Hey, lady, have a hot. It's almost Christmas and he's homeless.
Well,
bye, Buddy.
Bye, Vinny. Bye, Doug. Thanks a whole lot. And Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
I can stay here. Yeah, I can stay here.
Yes, but just for tonight. In the morning, we'll have to find you a place of your own.
But I like it here. Oh, wow, a model of a wind turbine machine.
You know what it is?
Oh, sure. I built a few of them back at Santa's workshop.
A few of them? How many?
Like 7,000, but this one's kind of weird looking. You would never get Santa to okay it.
So you know Santa pretty well then, do you?
Santa's like my best friend.
You still believe in all that flying reindeer stuff?
No, of course not. Santa hasn't flown reindeers in years and years. Ever since he got that nasty letter from PETA. Nowadays, the sleigh is powered by Christmas spirit alone, which is a problem because of people like you. Look at this place, no tinsel, no tree. Have you even written your letter to Santa Claus yet?
I'm sorry, Buddy, but I'm a little too old to write a letter to Santa Claus.
Me too. Way, way too old. Anyhow, I'm gonna fail if I don't get this stupid science project working.
I tell you what, if you get in the Christmas spirit right now and write your letter to Santa Claus, I'll fix your wind machine.
You will? Well, okay, it's a deal. Okay, Mom?
Okay, Mom.
Okay.
Well, how do we do this?
You're asking your 12-year-old daughter how to write a letter to Santa Claus? What does this say about our family, Mom?
Okay, settle down, Dr. Phil. Well, in the spirit of Christmas, what do you want for Christmas?
I don't know. I know what I don't want for Christmas. I don't want a check that's made out to cash or a corporate re-gift from some secret stash. I'd like a day with my dad.
Just a day?
Make that two. If you can do that, Santa, I'll believe in you.
I don't want a trip to some hip salon or a trendy perfume I'll never put on. I'd like to feel like he cares,
even if it's not true. If you can do that, Santa, I'll believe in you. Even though it's been years since you've heard from me, I thought it was worth a shot. If it's true that you're magic, I guarantee we can use all the magic you've got. I can get you some cookies if that's what it takes. I've heard stories and I know the deal. You just slide down the chimney and fix our mistakes. Now if only I thought you were real. If you were real.
Well, I guess that's our list. Our letter is done.
Is it really a list? If it adds up to one, make him part of our lives, not just passing through. If you can do that, Santa, I'll believe in you. Yes, if you do that, Santa, I'll believe in you. So good luck, Santa. Here's hoping you come through.
All fixed.
Yay, Buddy, you're the man!
Nice going, Buddy.
What the devil's going on here?
It's Buddy!
He's staying with us.
Hi, Dad.
Look, Buddy fixed my wind machine.
See?
Staying with us? What do you mean, Emily, he's staying with us?
Just for overnight, the police showed up with him.
Oh, for God's sake.
Hey, Dad, please, please, look at this. You just switch on the fan and...
Not now.
Michelle, why don't you show Buddy the spare room? You can sleep there. It has a futon.
What's a futon?
It's a type of bed.
Oh, I thought it was like a robot. I am futon.
I am futon.
Emily, there's no way.
Walter, he's homeless and it's freezing out. We couldn't just let him sleep on the street.
Fine. There's a youth hostel over by the West Side Highway. He can stay there.
Great idea. We'll send him in a cab over to a youth hostel in his elf costume. Or we could, you know, save the cab fare and just beat him up here.
All right, but I want him out of here by 8 a.m.
Okay.
Wow, buddy. Leftover spaghetti for breakfast is the best, huh?
I've never had spaghetti before.
No way!
Yes way! At the North Pole, we only eat from the five major food groups. Cookies, candies, candy canes, candy corns, and syrup. But something's missing. Syrup! You should never leave the house without it.
You like sugar, huh?
Is there sugar in maple syrup?
Yes.
Then yes.
You know sugar's bad for your teeth, though, right?
Yeah, that's why it's important to chew your sugar carefully, drink lots of syrup, and see your dentist three times a day.
Oh my God!
Emily, that lunatic is still here.
Yes, he is. And he isn't going anywhere.
What are you talking about?
Walter, I've been, very busy the past couple of days. You see, I had to yank a strand out of Buddy's hair. Then, as planned, wait till you're not there. Sneak in and find a hair on the sink.
Someone's been multitasking.
Then I check with my cousin Mel. He's a tech at Beth Israel.
Wait a sec. Should I call you a shriek?
No, dear, but thanks for asking. Melvin checks all the DNA. It's complex, but he works all day. This FedEx shows up here when he's done.
Anne?
Walter has an elf for a son.
Oh, no.
Yes, I knew it. I knew it. Dad, Dad, Dad.
I got a big brother. This is so cool. I can't believe it.
She can't believe it. Now what are we going to do? We can't just let him live here. He's insane.
I have our whole first day planned out for us, Dad. Just you and me. We'll start by making snow angels for 2 hours, and then we'll go ice skating. And after that, we'll eat a whole log of Tola's cookie dough as fast as we can, then come back home here and snuggle.
Listen, buddy, we're gonna have to snuggle another time because I've gotta go to work. You'll be staying here with your stepmommy.
Oh, no, he will not. I have my annual planning meeting this morning. Buddy, your father will be staying here with you.
I am this close to getting fired.
Well, then take him with you to work. I'm sure he could be very helpful around the office.
I can't believe this is happening to me. But if you're coming with me, you have to lose this costume. We'll stop at Brooks Brothers on the way and get you a suit.
Ooh, can it be red like Santa's?
Ooh, no.
Can I come? You can drop me off at school.
Sure, that's half the morning shot.
Come on, we'll go tell Francisco the doorman to flag us a cab.
Francisco, that's a fun name to say. Francisco.
He's an idiot. My son's an idiot.
Walter, tell me something. Was Susan a bright girl?
The brightest, Phi Beta Kappa.
Well, then we know where he got the idiot gene, don't we, darling?
turns out he had this secret love affair when he was in college. Uh-huh. I know, Walter, the Iceman Hobbs. And get this, there were consequences. Mm-hmm. Yep. He's 6 feet tall and incredibly sweet, which is bizarre considering the bloodline. Yeah? No, I saw it with my own two eyes. He came into the office, and I was just doing my thing like I do every day. Mm-hmm. And bright red curly hair. Yup. No, you would have never guessed it was Walter's son. They don't even look related, in my opinion, at least. I don't think so. I don't see it. Uh-huh. No, and here's the real kicker. He thinks he's a... Uh-oh, the Iceman cometh.
Good morning, Mr. Hobbs.
Morning, Sam.
Good morning, Sam. Morning.
Sarah.
Good morning, Sarah. I love your sweater. Very purpley.
Oh, buddy, congratulations. I hear it turns out you actually are Mr. Hobbs' son.
Hi, Deb. Yes, I am. You have such a pretty face. You could be on the cover of a Christmas card.
Oh, stop it. I hardly recognize you.
That's because I'm wearing human work clothes. Isn't it exciting?
Mm-hmm. Oh, Mr. Hobbs. Mr. Greenway got in about an hour ago from Chicago. He should be here any minute.
Today of all days.
Today of all days.
Deb, I'm gonna need some coffee now.
Ooh, let me do it. Me.
Deb, please be useful.
Buddy, why don't you help me put some documents through the shredder?
What's a shredder?
It's a machine that makes snow.
No way. Buddy the Elf, whichever color.
Hello? Please, don't touch anything. Just sit there and be quiet. I got a lot of work to do.
Dad?
What?
Why is the sky blue?
I don't know. Something to do with the sun and ultraviolet. I don't know.
Dad?
What?
What do rainbows feel like?
I don't know. Soft?
Dad?
Buddy!
What was my mom like? Susan Wells?
Buddy, that was a long time ago. What I mean is, we were just friends in college. You know, we drifted apart. She never told me about... Susan was fun and full of life. You would have liked her.
Mr. Greenway, sir.
Hobbs, my phone's been ringing off the hook. Angry mothers, kids crying. What happened to Jingles the Jolly Christmas Puppy? Did he make it to the North Pole? Did he ever get his magic bone?
It was an unfortunate oversight, Mr. Greenway. I'm fully prepared to blame my staff.
Don't try to pass the buck. It's your name on these proofs. And I'll tell you something else. Even if those two missing pages were in there, the book still would have sucked. You're hanging by a thread, Hobbs.
Hi, Mr. Greenway. I'm Buddy the Elf.
What? Who the devil is that?
He's my son.
I thought your kid was 12 years old.
I'm actually 30. That's this many.
What?
Deb, Buddy needs a break. Take him downstairs for some hot chocolate.
Can I have a chocolate monster?
A chocolate monster?
It's a hot chocolate with a chocolate bar on top. That way when the chocolate bar melts, it makes the hot chocolate even more chocolatey.
Works for me. Screw you, Weight Watchers!
Hobbs, you're out of a job unless you can come up with a blockbuster idea for a new Christmas book. I mean a through-the-roof national bestseller.
Sir, that's a lot easier said than done.
Yes, it is. So you better get your top writers on it, because I will be back in New York on the evening of December 24th. At that time, you will present to me, in exact detail, your plans for the new book. Happy holidays, Hobbs.
God, I'm a good guy, basically. Could you throw me a bone?
Snow.
Chocolate monster?
Thank you.
enjoy your dinner?
Greasy souvlaki on a stick is not dinner.
Oh, come on, but it's the world's greatest souvlaki.
No, it's the world's crappiest souvlaki. Sorry.
No, thank you for your feedback. I'll go home right now and change the sign.
Look, how about we just call it a night?
No, there's still so much left to do on our date. It's too early to take you home and get you into bed.
No?
Ooh, bells. May I try? Thank you, but this one's a little flat.
You're amazing on those things.
Thank you. I was in a band. It was me on bells, Charlie on toy piano, and Tiara on lead vocals and glockenspiel. We had a good thing going there for a little while, so Charlie started hitting a serve a little bit too hard. We had to call it quits. Those were crazy times. Hey, did I tell you? You look miraculous.
Miraculous, huh? Okay, well, you look miraculous too. That elf get-up made you look incredibly dorky.
Thanks.
That wasn't a problem.
I know. It's the night before Christmas. Let's do something Christmassy.
You want Christmassy? Okay, follow me.
Ooh, can we go ice skating?
I'm not a very good skater.
That's okay, neither am I. Santa says I'm a hazard. He calls me Edward Scissorfeet.
Stop. Let's make a pact. If you try to be less elfy, I'll try to be less crabby.
Okay. I'd like it if you'd be less crabby.
I came here last year, too. My first Christmas in New York.
Oh, where'd you come from?
L.A.
L.A.? Never heard of that before. I don't think Santa goes there.
He doesn't. Christmases there are surreal. No snow.
No snow?
I've never even seen snow. I've always wanted to.
That is the saddest thing I've ever heard.
Yeah, I've been here almost 2 years and it hasn't snowed once. You know, when I was a kid, I dreamed of having a snowy Christmas Eve dinner at Tavern on the Bean Green with Billy Crystal. That sounds so stupid.
No, it doesn't. But who is Billy Crystal? He sounds magical.
He's an actor. He was in my favorite movie of all time, City Slickers. Anyway, last year I spent Christmas Eve in a 400 square foot studio apartment with no heat, binge watching Gilmore Girls on Netflix. Sad, huh?
That is sad. But Jovi, I'm gonna make a Christmas dream come true. We're gonna have Tavern on the Green Christmas Eve dinner.
I don't think so. For one thing, it's been closed for months. It just reopened, now it's even harder to get in.
But my dad can get us a table. He can do anything.
Buddy, don't promise things you can't deliver.
Jovi, I promise we're gonna make your Christmas dream come true.
Wow, I might actually have a real Christmas.
You see, you do have Christmas spirit.
I guess I do. And a little.
But now you have to spread it. And the best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear.
I told you, I don't sing.
What do you mean?
I mean, I don't sing for anyone at any time under any circumstances. That includes birthdays, bar mitzvahs, and especially Christmas, okay?
Come on, Jovi, singing can be easy.
Please stop.
It's fun, it's free, and best of all, it's
totally cheesy.
Come on, all you have to do is move your voice up higher, high, low, high, low. Just sing a Christmas song. It's like magic if things go wrong. Just spread some Christmas cheer by singing loud for all to hear.
People are staring.
That's the point! Just sing a Christmas song and keep on singing all season long. Think of the joy you'll bring if you just close your eyes and sing. And if you're short on cheer, think about that year you woke up to find a brand new snow hat. several nights. Your mother claimed that she heard proof. There were reindeer on the roof. Remember who you were back then. Let those moments live again. Come on, Jovi, sing!
Just sing a Christmas song.
That's it?
It's like magic if things go wrong.
Keep going!
Just spread some Christmas cheer by singing loud for all to
populated only by tomatoes.
Tomatoes.
Yeah, little tomato people. They're busily preparing for Christmas, but little do they know, the mean tomato on top of the mountain is planning on stealing Christmas this year.
You're describing the Grinch.
But with tomatoes.
You're an idiot, Chadwick. Greenway's gonna fire us all if we can't come up with something good. Can you please grasp the seriousness of the situation? Where's Matthews?
He's out working a lead.
He's what?
I got it.
You got it?
An original idea, I hope.
We got something better than idea. I
know. We got a book.
You are, of course, familiar with the Christopher Smith.
Are you kidding? Christopher Smith was the greatest writer of Christmas stories who ever lived. When you think of Christmas, you think of Chris Smith.
So you'd be happy if we brought him in?
He's dead, you morons.
Mr. Hobbs, ignore him. I met a guy who deals in used furniture, high-end stuff, from the homes of prominent dead writers. So, he recently acquired a desk from the one Chris Smith.
And in this desk, he finds a secret drawer.
And in this drawer, he finds a manuscript.
A lost Chris Smith Christmas story.
A lost Chris Smith Christmas story?
It's a Chris Smith Christmas for Mr. Walter Hobbs.
My God. It's beautiful.
Isn't it? The illustrations.
And the story will make you cry.
I can't believe I'm actually holding an original Christopher Smith in my hands.
Yeah, just be careful. It's our only copy.
What are you, crazy? What if somebody spills coffee on it? Make a copy.
Relax. The printer is out of toner. Deb's replacing it now. Just for now, be careful with it, Mr. Hobbs.
This could be huge.
I'm in love, and I don't care who knows it.
Buddy, please, we're very busy.
Dad, I'm gonna need a reservation for a Tavern on the Green on Christmas Eve at 7 o'clock. And $400.
Mr. Hobbs, the guy's in the lobby.
Okay, buddy, just sit here. I'll be with you in a minute. Well, bring the guy up. I want to thank him personally.
Yeah. No, that's the thing. He doesn't want to thank you. He wants $300,000.
What?
It's a small price to pay, Mr. Hobbs. It's a modern classic.
We'll make it back on the film rights alone.
I don't know. That's a lot of money.
Mr. Hobbs, we've been trying to come up with an idea for a story, but we've got nothing.
We're idiots.
And then this comes along. It's a gift from God.
And God gets angry when you do not accept his gifts.
Okay, fine, I'll write the guy a check. I mean, Greenway will understand, right? In fact, he'll be pleased. I mean, this is gonna be...
Snow!
What have you done? That was the only copy.
What?
I can't deal with this anymore. Just go back to the apartment, get your things, and leave.
For where?
I don't care! I don't care where you go. I don't care that you're an elf. I don't care that you're my son. Just get out of my life now.
I only tried my best to be everything you'd expect from me, but I let you down, and so I guess we're done. So now how can I say I'm the world's greatest son?
Skip old Santa. I'm on. Oh, sorry. Sorry. Just made a quick trip to the cocoa cart, if you know what I mean. Single malt cocoa. Whew, that really curls the shoes. Now, where were we? Ah, yes, Buddy. He was not having a very Merry Christmas, was he? In fact, it was the worst he could remember since the time the elves got into that bad eggnog. After Walter said those terrible things, Buddy went back to his apartment, got back in his elf suit, and wrote a note.
Dear Mom, Dad, and Michelle, I'm sorry I ruined your lives. I also feel real upset about pouring that bottle of maple syrup into your DVD player. My bad. Anyway, thanks for the nifty suit and coat, but I won't be needing them anymore. I don't belong here with you. I don't belong at the North Pole either. I'll never forget you. Love and goodbye forever, Buddy. P.S. Merry Christmas.
After that, Buddy wandered all day and all night, cold and alone, through the streets of the city. He grew hungry and happened to stumble upon the one place a sad elf could get a cheap meal on Christmas Eve.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I can't believe any of this.
Every single
boy, babe.
This is one Christmas season I thought would never end.
It gets longer every year.
You're telling me I got a bruise on my thigh in the shape of a kid's butt.
I'm not late, am I?
No, we still got Chow Mein. Boo goo guy pan.
Boy, may I never put on this suit again.
Tough year.
I would have a sugar to Christmas.
Is this a Chinese restaurant?
No, I got a thing for dragons.
Oh, sorry, I'll keep looking.
Oh, too depressed for sarcasm, huh? Well, come on in, honey. We got a special offer. Out of work Christmas pimps. You like cotton salad soup?
No.
Hey, it's that crazy elf I was telling y'all about.
You mean the guy who beat up Larry Spinoli?
Hey, buddy, come sit next to Santa Claus.
Now, I know none of you are the real Santa Claus, but don't worry, I won't hit you.
Mom explained to me that you guys only dress up as Santa Claus for the kids who can't make it to the North Pole to see the real Santa Claus. I get it now. You make a lot of kids really happy.
Not anymore.
Years ago, kids would light up when they saw us. You felt special, you know?
Now they just sit on your lap and text each other.
People get no respect.
Yeah, no respect at all.
No respect.
No respect for Santa Claus.
Used to be, I'd stand on the busiest corner, ring my bell, and make the people smile. Nowadays, they pass me by, and who knows why? Could it be that old Saint Nick's gone out of style?
Well, nobody cares, nobody cares, nobody cares about Santa. They're reaching their list, and you can dismiss, 'cause nobody cares about Santa Claus.
Hours to see me, all that joy could almost make you cry.
Now they think I'm just passé, some dumb cliche, and it makes me wonder why I even try.
Well, nobody cares, nobody cares, nobody cares about Santa. Now they ain't got your beer, 'cause nobody cares about Santa Claus. Is this all a sign?
Is this all an awful sign?
Of a sad decline.
Miserable sad decline. I never knew such disrespect could ever have existed. No wonder this whole city has been.
Don't you guys want to hang out some more? Sing songs, complain.
Don't you have a family to go home to?
Well, my dad and I had a huge fight, and he said he never wants to see me again.
Ah, forget about it. Don't you know Christmas is all about fighting with your family?
That's what presents are for, too. Making up.
Listen to the Santas. Get your old man a present.
A present?
Sure. That's the thing about Christmas. When you're a kid, it's all about what you're gonna get. But when you're an adult, it's all about what you're gonna get other people. My socks. Maybe a Snuggie. I don't know. But it's the one day of year. Everybody gets to be Santa Claus. Oh, that reminds me. It's Christmas Eve and I gotta get my wife a present. Hopefully Dwayne Reed's is still open.
Christmas Eve? Oh my gosh. Dovey, I totally forgot. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Growing dim while others deck the halls, you dream of decking him. My choice in men has always been pathetic, I suppose. The guy who stole my credit cards, the guy who tried on my clothes. And so a row of self-help books line my bedroom shelf. Well, there's one rule those books forgot. You never fall in love with an elf. His endless talk of Christmas Town will test your every yourself. You're halfway through a Christmas song called Never Fall in Love with an Elf. The holidays will seem bittersweet while you're alone in bed. But how can one girl ever compete with a magic fat guy in a flying?
I know you're super mad, but wow, you look more miraculous than ever.
And you look seasonally appropriate.
Thanks.
You were 2.5 hours late.
I have a really good explanation.
Go ahead.
I totally forgot about our date.
That's your explanation? You forgot?
Well, I remembered, but for a long time I forgot, and so that's why I'm late. Is this Tavern on the Green with all the lights? Pretty.
Yes. I'm sure some lucky couple had a wonderful evening sitting at our table.
No, they didn't.
Why not?
Because I didn't get its table. You see, I was gonna ask my dad to get us one, but...
But you forgot.
Well, I remembered, but then he got really mad at me for making it snow in his office, so...
Stop! Just stop! I can't take any more of your crazy stories!
But Jovi, it's true! And I'm so sorry I ruined your Christmas dream!
Forget it. It's my fault. I knew you couldn't get us a table, but still I got all dressed up and came here. And then an hour went by, then another hour, and I waited. I didn't leave. Why? Because our date on Thursday was the only good time I've had in the last 1.5 years. How sad is that?
That is sad. But it's nice too.
I just thought if anyone could give me a real Christmas, it would be you. Lower your expectations so you don't get disappointed. I should have that tattooed on my forehead.
Jovi, I feel so bad about this, like sick to my stomach. like I just ate 1,006 of Juicy Fruit. The last thing in the whole world I wanted to do was upset you.
I don't want to talk about it anymore. I'm cold and my feet are killing me in these heels.
Can I just give you a Christmas present?
Now is the worst possible time.
Here, this is what New York looks like when it snows. Shake it. Pretty, huh? The snowflakes are actually smaller than the buildings. Keep it. Santa, I know you're not gonna believe me, but Santa Claus gave that to me when I left the North Pole.
Oh, buddy, I so wish that were true. Goodbye. At the North Pole either? Nobody wants me, nobody needs me. Poor Buddy, in wandering New York City in his dorky elf suit.
Why did he do it?
He had a fight with your father. This really is amazing. I can barely draw a straight line on one of these things.
We have to find him, we have to bring him home.
We will find him. And when we do, honey, I think we need to get Buddy some help.
What do you mean, help?
Professional help. Honey, Buddy is crazy.
Mom.
No, he is. We have to accept that.
He's my brother.
I know. You have a crazy brother. Lots of people do.
Just because somebody believes in Santa Claus does not mean they're crazy.
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does.
What about little kids? Are they crazy too?
Well, that's different. If a little kid believes in a talking purple dinosaur, it's delightful. If he still believes when he's 30, it's profoundly disturbing. Honey, just because Buddy is crazy doesn't mean we should love him any less. I have a friend who's a psychiatrist. You remember Barry with the Ferrari? I'm gonna give him a call right now, and maybe he can tell us where we should look for Buddy.
Oh, Buddy, where did you go?
Mom? 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 Mom?
What?
Mom.
I saw a tiny sleigh make its tiny way right across the sky. There wasn't time to think, there wasn't time to blink before it zoomed right by. And everything I knew, and everything that you knew too is absolutely now untrue, because without a doubt there is a Santa Claus.
You're being ridiculous.
Mom, look. Oh my God! I just saw him too, yet my whole life through he seemed fake too. Couldn't Santa see what a fantasy he appeared to be? And everything I thought is tangled up in one big knot. The world out there has clearly got its flaws. If they can't say there is a Santa Claus, and Rudolph's nose really glows and guides him through the night. The beard like snow, the ho ho. Easter eggs are hidden by a rabbit. I just thought that I'd been hocus pocus. And does this mean there's any truth to a fairy who might buy your tooth?
Come on, Mother, let's stay focused.
I can't believe
he was right there. He's over.
It's hard to be sedate or keep your head on straight when fairy tales come true. Though I can't complain, cause if I'm insane, that means you.
Be exact that Santa's real, in fact he always was.
I know I've had my
You have to work on Christmas Eve. Tough luck, so do I. Get this through your heads. Greenway is on his way, and if he doesn't buy our pitch, we're all fired.
But we've been trying all night. We don't have a pitch.
I'm painfully aware of that. Just keep thinking.
What about this? A poor family of asparagus children, eagerly waiting for Santa, but they're self-conscious about the way their pee smells.
I want your resignation on my desk in the morning. In the meantime, keep thinking.
May I make a suggestion?
Anything.
Okay. Well, whenever we visited my Grammy in Budapest, she would tell us the story of little Palko, the one-legged boy. Every year, he wished and he wished. And one Christmas morning, there it was, under the tree, from Santa.
A leg?
Yes, a leg.
A human leg?
Well, he'd been a very good boy that year.
That's the most disgusting story I've ever heard.
Well, it's incredibly touching when you hear it in Hungarian.
Dad, the most amazing thing just happened.
Emily, you have no idea how important it is that I continue working on this pitch.
No, Walter, we need to talk right now.
Fine. Deb, keep an eye out for Greenway, will you? What?
First of all, Buddy is missing.
He ran away. He left a note on Etch-a-Sketch.
We brought it with us in the cab, but, you know, the slide is shaken. Those darn things erase themselves.
Emily, you know that tonight, of all nights, I have to...
I knew it. He's not going to help us.
Michelle, you don't understand.
No, you don't understand. It's not just Buddy. Me and Mom both saw...
Oh, Mr. Greenway, how lovely to see you. Can I get you a hot buttered rum? Maybe a double?
No, where's Hobbs?
Just please give me 10 minutes to make this pitch, and I'll look for Buddy with you. I'll look for any elf you want.
All right, let's make this quick. I got a plan to catch back to Chicago.
Christmas party?
Hardly. Remember Mark Zanko back on acquisitions? He gave some con artist $300,000 of company money to some fake Chris Smith.
What a loser. You should fire that guy.
Now, let's hear your pitch, Hobbs, and it better be good.
Okay. Let's start with the cover. Picture this under a Christmas tree, a little boy's leg.
Hi, Dad. Everybody, I'm so
Buddy!
Sorry.
Buddy, are you okay? We were so worried about you.
Well, I think I just broke up with my girlfriend.
Oh. Wait, you have a girlfriend?
Buddy, the most amazing thing happened.
Can we just do this later?
Dad, I know you're mad at me and I want to fix that.
Hobbs, what's your family doing here? This is a business meeting.
I want to get you a Christmas present, but I don't have any money. So what'd you rather have? 1,000 butterfly kisses or a bracelet made of my hair?
Neither. You want to give me a Christmas present? Give me a story to pitch.
What? Are you telling me, Hobbs, that you don't have a story to pitch?
No, Mr. Greenway, of course I have a story to pitch. It's about Palko, this one-legged kid who lives on an asparagus farm.
Dad! I have the perfect story, and this is such a better present than a bracelet made of hair.
Hold it, buddy. You can't.
Yes, he can. Go ahead. It can't be any worse than little Palko, the one-legged asparagus boy.
Yes, sir. It all started on Christmas morning about 30 years ago. Page one, fresh out of toys, Santa makes his way back. When he hears a small noise from inside of his pack, a sound that's not unlike a baby's cry. It's enough to make the jolly guy perplexed.
And?
Next.
A baby inside Santa's bag. Not a bad start.
He's buying it. Keep going.
Page two, back from his ride, Santa gathers his elves.
He gathers his elves.
And they quickly decide they'll raise the baby themselves. The North Pole isn't made for humans, though. And soon that phony elf began to grow so tall.
Learns he's human after all.
Right!
Good one, Dad!
It's the story of Buddy the Elf. It's the story of Buddy the Elf. It's the story of... It's kind of brilliant if I say so myself. It's the story of Buddy the Elf.
So the baby finds out he's a human.
Well, then he goes to New York, and, things get complicated.
Page 3, his father's at work when Buddy walks through the door. His dad is sort of a jerk, and Buddy's banned from the floor.
His father's not prepared to be a dad to a son he never knew he had.
But soon, he'll be forced to change his tune.
He'll be forced to change his tune.
It's the story of Buddy the Elf. It's the story of Buddy the Elf. It's the story of, it's kind of brilliant if you said so himself. It's the story of Buddy the Elf.
And maybe Buddy helps his dad in a setting much like this.
And maybe his father learns a son is something he can't dismiss. They might learn that they need each other much more than they know. Maybe the point of the story is it's never too late to grow.
It's never too late to grow.
I do. I love that story, love that story, love that story.
He loves that story, loves that story, loves that story. He loves that story, loves that story, loves that story. It's the story of Buddy the Elf. It's the story of Buddy the Elf. It's the story of, and the books will fly right off the shelf. It's the story of Buddy the Elf.
Mr. Greenway, thanks a lot.
Just one thing. Instead of an elf, let's make it a horse.
Excuse me?
I want to make it a horse instead of an elf.
You mean a horse?
Like with a saddle and tail?
Yeah, a horse.
Interesting. Why?
Market research. Horses score really big with the gweens.
Gweens?
Girl tweens.
So you want our Christmas story to be about a horse that grows up at the North Pole?
Yeah, obviously it's gonna need a little tweaking.
It's genius.
It's outside of the box.
There is no box.
That is the stupidest thing I have ever heard.
Michelle.
You're an idiot.
That's it. Hobbs, what's with these kids of yours?
Mr. Greenway.
Oh, come on, Buddy, the Christmas horse.
Sir, I'm not a horse.
I have had enough of this. I don't need to be lectured by kids on how to sell kids' books to kids. You two, take your smart aleck remarks and get out of here.
Sorry.
Sorry. Wait. Mr. Greenway, Buddy and Michelle are my kids, and I prefer that you didn't insult them.
And I'd prefer that you keep your wife and your whole weirdo family out of the office and do your job. Now, you got a good idea here, Hobbs. With some work, it could be a million seller. So this is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna cancel my flight, and we're gonna work all night and all day tomorrow until
tomorrow? Tomorrow's Christmas.
You got a problem with that?
Yeah. You know what, Mr. Greenway? I quit.
What?
I quit.
Let me get this straight. You wanna spend Christmas on the unemployment line?
No, I wanna spend Christmas with my family, but I'd be happy to spend it anywhere as long as it's not with you.
All right, Dad.
Yeah, Dad.
Eureka, Hobbs. I haven't spent Christmas with my family in over 30 years. That's why I'm president of this company, and you're a nobody.
Mr. Greenway.
What?
Merry Christmas.
I quit. I actually quit my job.
I've never been more proud of you, Walter.
Buddy, we saw him. We saw Santa Claus.
What?
He flew right past our window with the red suit and the big sack of toys, the whole bit, and he landed in Central Park.
He landed?
Yeah, right by the boathouse.
Why would he do that? Unless the sleigh couldn't fly properly. Oh, Santa was afraid this would happen. We have to go help him. Come on.
Buddy, Michelle, wait for your dad.
Depend on the children, they believe, and I'd be skyward bound. Now it seems there's not enough belief around to get me and my sleigh up off the ground. I gave it a try. Oh, how can I fly when nobody cares about
it? Santa!
Buddy, am I glad to see you. The darn sleigh won't fly.
I know.
In this whole city, there's not enough Christmas spirit.
Tell me about it.
8 million people who don't believe in you. A guy can't help but take that personally.
Well, I believe in you.
It's the same every year. I get a boost over Vermont, but then as soon as I hit the tri-state area, it's lights out. It's like I'm flying through a black hole. But it's never crashed before.
Santa, I have so much to tell you.
Buddy, you shouldn't have run off like that.
Mom, Dad, Michelle, this is my really, really good friend, Santa Claus.
Oh my God.
That's the guy we saw. That's him. And he flew past our window right there. That's him. Santa!
Michelle, I got your letter.
You did?
Sure. It's right here on my iPad. I used to schlep around that big book of Christmas wishes, but not anymore. Technology. Let's see. Letters to Santa. No, that's Angry Birds. Letters to Santa. Michelle Hobbs. All I want for Christmas is a day with my dad. A real tearjerker.
Oh man, I can't wait to tell the kids at school about this little freak.
Mr. Claus, I've got to tell you, I'm a huge, huge fan. I mean, at least I was. And now I am again. I loved you in Miracle on 34th Street.
And this is my dad.
Hey, Walter. So can I take you off the naughty list or not?
You know, it's been a crazy week. Found out that I had a son, I told off my boss, I even quit my job. I think I need some time to think things over.
Dad, Santa is standing right in front of you.
Okay, what I mean is, it doesn't matter if I can't wrap my head around all these things. Buddy, what's important is, if you believe in Santa Claus, I will too.
It's good enough for me. You're off the naughty list.
Yes!
What's happening?
It's just not enough. Man, what I wouldn't do for some magical reindeer right now. Thank you, PETA. Well, that's it.
Well, what do you mean?
I mean, it's over. No more Christmas. You know, it's time for me to consider another line of work. My brother-in-law, he has a Chipotle in Boca.
Santa!
I'm not talking about working there. I mean, a franchise. Come on, don't look at me like that. What am I supposed to do if nobody believes in me? Oh, I hate to disappoint all those children.
I can't give up. I know I can get you the Christmas spirit you need. I just have to find enough people to talk to. I need to borrow this.
Buddy, I haven't backed it up!
Denon, NY1, continuing our live coverage from Central Park. No evidence has yet been found of the UFO that apparently crashed in the park earlier this evening. But could there be another explanation? Perhaps what you millions of New York One viewers saw was Santa Claus making his rounds in the skies above Manhattan, delivering toys to all the good little boys and girls.
That's exactly what people saw. Only the sleigh crashed because there isn't enough Christmas spirit.
Seems that one of Santa's elves has joined us.
I know. Everyone thinks I'm crazy, but I've come to tell you that Santa is real.
I'm afraid that's all the time we have for today.
It's right here in Santa's iPad. You, ma'am, what's your name?
Danielle
Lambert?
Daniel Lambert. Yes, Christmas 1979. Santa brought you a red Schwinn bicycle with a bell shaped like Miss Piggy.
How'd you know that?
And you are, ma'am?
Emma Van Brocklin.
Christmas 1960. A Bobby Rydell lunchbox.
I love Bobby Rydell.
What is this? Some kind of a trick?
What's your name?
Charlotte Denon, New York 1.
Charlotte Denon, New York 1. Yes, for Christmas this year, you want a Tiffany engagement ring and your boyfriend Dwayne to stop dragging his feet and pop the question.
Who told you to say that? My mother?
No, it's right here.
Okay, that's it. I don't know how you're doing this, but I'm not an idiot. Everybody knows there's no Santa Claus. Oh my God, I ruined Christmas.
You didn't ruin Christmas. No one can. I could read names out of that thing all night long and you still wouldn't believe me, would you? Well, it doesn't matter, because Christmas is a lot more than just Santa Claus. Christmas is sleeping on a futon. It's going ice skating with your girlfriend and kissing her for the very first time under a big glittery Christmas tree. It's traveling miles and miles to be with your family through tunnels where cars honk their horns at you the whole time and truck drivers yelling things that no person, just as a human being, much less an elf. It's hoping that on Christmas morning, all the cars and the big gray office buildings and the piles of garbage will be covered in snow. You see, you can't ruin Christmas. It's all around you. You just have to get into the spirit of it. And the best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear. Everybody, sing, sing. Anybody?
Just sing a Christmas song. It's like magic if things go wrong. Just spread some Christmas cheer by singing loud for all to hear. Come on, people, get into it.
Jovi, you're here. I thought you were mad at me.
I was, but then you made it snow.
Just sing a Christmas song and keep on singing all season long. Think of the joy you'll bring if you just close your eyes and sing. Just sing a Christmas song. It's like magic if things go wrong. Just spread some Christmas cheer by singing loud for all to hear.
Just sing a Christmas song and keep on singing all season long. Think of the joy you'll bring if you just close your eyes.
Christmas to all, and to all a good night. I proclaimed as I continued on my rounds. Funny story, in all the excitement, I completely forgot to deliver to Fuquay Varina. Slipped my mind. It's okay, I went back on the 26th and made good. Soon after this, Walter started his own publishing house, Hobbs and Sons, and Buddy's story went on to become the best-selling children's book in the world. And it probably won't come as a surprise to you that they all lived happily ever after. And that's the end. It's the end of our story. Well, almost the end, except this one last little part.
Merry Christmas, Santa.
Merry Christmas, kids.
Merry Christmas, everybody. I'm singing. I'm at the North Pole and I'm singing. I've got a wife and I'm singing. We did a special kind of hug I'd never heard about before. When it was over, I was singing. And now we've got a kid, so I'm singing.
Shh, Buddy, you'll wake the baby.
It's okay, Papa Hobbs. The baby loves Buddy singing.
All I have to do is sing to stop a string of sleepy sobs.
Cause nobody likes a Christmas song like little Buddy Hobbs. And as long as middle name just happens to be Sparkle Jolly Twinkle Jiggly.
Now we spend each Christmas here dressed up in North Pole festive wear.
And our son's got Jovi's eyes.
And Buddy's bright red curly hair.
But you'll find that Buddy Jr. takes after me. I'm Sparkle Jolly Twinkle Jiggly.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
And when the baby is grown, he'll ride in my sleigh and help deliver gifts galore.
We'll teach him Christmas never gets in the way. Look who's at the front door.